Hello to everybody, Friedrich Schaffen 2016. Here we are in La Sportiva Boots. I'm Pietro, glad to introduce you the news of La Sportiva. This year there are many news and they go really into the specific to satisfy specific categories. We have many models, and let's start to see them together in the fastest way I can. Before everything, in the performance line, which is the DNA of La Sportiva, the best climbing shoes for hard climbing. We have this lacing system shoe, which is called Kataki, and it is at the top of the category. It is quite a stiff, consistent shoes, it's not a slipper. So, small footholds, vertical terrain, slightly overhanging. I wouldn't go climbing with this on big, big overhangs, where it's better to use softer shoes. This is a little bit an evolution of the Katana lace, but we changed a little bit these shoes, we changed a little bit the shape of the inner sole, and also the materials of the upper, in order to make the shoe more sensitive and more adaptable to your foot. But enough, always with the same consistency and so the same power in of the sole of the lower part of the shoe. Of course, we decided to put the S-Heel system, stability heel system device in this shoe. This is a new heel which seems to be the best in the market now. This shovel is done with two rubbers in the inside part. Under this rubber there is a very stiff one which you cannot squeeze because you always heel hook in this side of the shoe, giving power in this side of the shoes and having a very stiff and unsqueezable part in this side, the shoe, the heel cannot turn in this sense. Then outside, the rubber which is outside, it's really, really soft and really, really sticky. So we are sure that this is at the moment the top level of the heels for heel hooking. This, as other La Sportiva models, exist already now in men version and woman version. The men version and the woman version, they share the same volumes. The woman version, it's just a little bit softer with the thickness of the P3 system a little bit thinner, and a sole which is a little bit softer, which is the XS grip instead of the XS edge of the men version, and this rubber band a little bit thinner in the woman version. Going on the performance line, Miura, it was a historical, super successful model of La Sportiva. It was born 20 years ago. The shape of these shoes was always perfect, and we missed just one little detail to have a really modern and super performance shoes. What did we change here in these shoes compared to the normal Miura lace? We just put the P3 system inside, the performance power platform inside. What does it mean? This shoe, after a while, after some use, will tend to turn up, and so it won't be anymore that strong and precise in small footholds. With this Miura 20 with P3, the shoe always keep his aggressive shape downturn, and so you are always the maximum. You have always the maximum of efficiency in really pushing on small footholds. We have the signature of Adam Ondra in this shoe. This was a prototype that I tested already more than 10 years ago, and we had it there. A little bit hidden under the table. Then I gave it as a test to Adam once. like others tester, he was enthusiastic of this change, and he told me this is really a super, super good shoe. He climbed the three hardest route in the world, the 3 9B plus of the world. They were climbed by Adam with Miura, with a normal Miura, but we did a better Miura, so we thought it was the case to dedicate to him this shoe. I really wish you the best climb with this prototype that was, until last year when was the normal Miura, started to be a little bit old, and now it's again, it goes again to the top of the category of the performances. Out of the performance category, I would be glad to introduce you just one important news. In the all-round category, where it's important to have shoes that are comfortable and durable, we have this big news, another historical model of La Sportiva, but we did it in the eco version, very, very important. There are some parts totally recycled and some parts which are eco-friendly. Eco-friendly is the leather, which is which has a tannery process done without heavy metals, no mercury, no chrome, no other unhealthy stuff. This is more healthy in your foot and when you work this material. The lacing and the webbing behind, in their previous life, they were fishing nets, totally recycled. But the most important aspect is the rubber. For the first time in the life, there is a rubber which is recycled 100%. And the most interesting aspect is that to make this rubber, we use 100% totally the rubber waste that comes from the construction of other La Sportiva shoes. So we are able now to reduce so much the waste of the rubber that every day are gone. And most of them, they finish here to do this shoe. It is a shoe for adults and for people who care about the environment, who start to think about the future. This is the first step, I think, of something that will go on. I really thank you, and I really wish you best climbs with our products. Ciao.